All right, I think we are ready to get started. Thank you for attending the first of our 20-minute webinar series. We'll have one every month on the third Tuesday of the month. And instead of taking up an hour of your time, it will be a quick 20 minutes. We will be covering some NetBeans use cases with our customers, along with all of our new releases and new product features, which one of which we'll go over today, the remote worker Wi-Fi monitoring feature. Next slide, please. Thank you. Okay, so today we'll be hearing from Greg and Panos from the NetBeans team, and Panos will be doing a live demo as well. So take it away, Greg.
Thanks, Jess. So we'll take to the next slide here. Hanno? Wi-Fi obviously is a root cause of, among many, when it comes to the remote worker network performance issues. Discovering it can be really key to remote organization productivity. And as you're probably well aware, if you're on this webinar, you've got consumer grade network equipment, you've got potential issues with VoIP, video conferencing, ISPs, backhaul, performance issues, VPN, which you know doesn't scale very well, right? But then an even bigger challenge is IT ops support. You can't just drop in like you can, even in some remote offices where you have nearby IT ops training. So there's an extra strain on help desk. And then even more importantly, the productivity of the network team as well as the remote worker can be impacted by the network performance issues, even more so than in a corporate headquarters. So to frame the demo, I'll just kind of, you know, the supported platforms of the remote desktop agent, Windows, Mac, Linux, version 7.0, which we released end of last year, beginning of this year, functionality from availability, throughput, latency, DNS, HTTP performance, VoIP, Wi-Fi, et cetera. And then two approaches to the dashboard, one on-prem and one hosted in the cloud. So as you look back over the 7-year history of NetBeans and their laser focus on user experience, on raw data, you know, versus sample, and on ease of deployment, really across, you know, the prem, for public cloud, website, SaaS, VoIP, web conferencing, this new solution now extends all of those benefits into the remote worker and is now augmented with Wi-Fi network performance monitoring. So Pano, you want to take it from here? And we'll want it, there you go.
Thank you, Greg. Right, so to tie everything together, we released last summer our end user monitoring agent. That was our first response to this, you know, unprecedented, of course, need to support workers working from home. And as of last week, we released the second version of our work from home agent. And the main addition there is the monitoring of Wi-Fi metrics for end user devices, Mac and Windows, and also improved VoIP monitoring, which of course is very important these days. Everybody's on Zoom calls, on video conferencing calls every day. Totally limited to Zoom, of course, can be tailored to any type of VoIP or video service. And all these, of course, are supported by the existing NetBeans infrastructure and dashboard, where you can set targets around different services like DNS or applications like HTTP and run performance, end user experience performance tests that measure bandwidth, latency, et cetera, that complete, I would say, the end user experience monitoring capabilities of NetBeans. And without further ado, I'm gonna move to the demo. We're going to cover just very briefly what NetBeans is, the types of agents we have, what are the additions of our new release as of last week, the Wi-Fi metrics and the VoIP. And let's jump into the demo. So very briefly, for the ones already familiar with NetBiz, many things are haven't changed, right? I would say the main contribution of this last release was to add additional metrics to existing types of agents that we already support. But just to give a brief overview here, we have the NOC type of dashboard view, where we have an aggregate of the different agents and tests and Wi-Fi incidents issues you may have on your NetBiz monitoring agents, right? For example, as an example here, I'm showing here on the lower left corner the agent performance plot, where each dot is an agent. And depending on how many alerts or incidents or warnings the agent might have triggered on it, you may have an agent on the lower left corner, which means everything is okay. Jordan's agent has zero alerts and warnings, while some other agents here I see have like a number of alerts, right? This Wi-Fi agent, for example, in our headquarters has a number of alerts open right now. And this expands more on the target view, where we talk about HTTP performance, for example, around applications or services, and the Wi-Fi metrics on the right-hand side. On the agent view, just briefly again, we talked about the way NetBiz monitors networks and user experience. A quick overview is that NetBiz, of course, is an agent-based monitoring tool. Since the beginning, we're supporting mostly hardware agents tailored to monitor infrastructure networks, WAN networks, on-campus networks, right? This was possible with the wired agents that plug into the access layer, or Wi-Fi agents that are deployed as sensors around your network, and you monitor the user experience by collecting Wi-Fi metrics, signal strength, link quality, and by using active tests, right? So, and of course, the complete picture of your infrastructure was complemented by the NetBiz virtual agent that could spin up on any virtual infrastructure, cloud agents for AWS, Azure, etc. Now, the remote worker front, we introduced the Mac and Windows agent last summer, and we see here we have six agents connected to this dashboard, three Windows and three Mac. So the agent runs constantly on the user's laptop. The installation is pretty straightforward, like any typical application. You download an installer, next, and you have an agent popping up on your dashboard. And of course, distribution also through tools like Intune or others is, typical of the installer we use. So you see here an overview of each agent. We see what type of connections each agent has. The one here that's running on my laptop right now, I'm in San Jose. I have an Ethernet connection. Right now I'm not on Wi-Fi, I'm plugged in my router. I have my Wi-Fi connected as well, and my VPN, right? So very typical. You might not have a wired and a Wi-Fi connection usually, but I do here, but we support both obviously, right? And if I click on it, we can see here a more detailed view of this agent. So I can see here very quickly what is the connectivity status for its interface, my IP, and something I would say very critical when we troubleshoot connectivity issues usually, for example, driver information, right? You very well know that drivers are usually, whether they're updates or pending updates, or there's a new driver released, that may cause hell into your connectivity and device connectivity. We can give you information here, and you can know for each user what Wi-Fi card they're using, what driver they're running, and you may be able to identify problems by looking at that information only. Now, the rest of the view here, in terms of the tests, it's similar across all agents. So you can run a set of active monitoring tests. Think about the scenario where you have a user working from home, connect over the Wi-Fi, and they have, you have a split tunnel VPN. You see here on my laptop, all of them are up, Wi-Fi is up, VPN is up, and I can run, you know, my, let's say, internet connectivity test by just doing a simple ping test to Google, a DNS test, right, trying to resolve google.com or an HTTP test to Google, right? So that monitors my uplink to the internet. And then, of course, you can set up also a VPN test. In this case, I have a ping and a tracer to my VPN concentrator. And I can also keep an eye on both of those pipes. And typically, you can also monitor other services like a CRM application or YouTube, etc. The one critical addition we did here with this release is the ability to monitor voice quality. Now, the way we do this is by simulating, taking approximation, but it's very close one, so I'm going to show you, demonstrate in a little bit here, where we measure, in this specific example, we measure the latency running a ping test to a Zoom server. We don't monitor only latency, but also jitter, okay? And you can see here how it's between 0 and maybe 10 milliseconds, which is not too bad. And from the jitter, packet loss, and latency, you can derive a MOS score. Everything looks fine for me right now. You see here a MOS score for around 4.4, which is as good as can get. But what I'm going to do to demonstrate you how this looks like, I'm going to introduce a little bit of network degradation intentionally. So don't worry. You probably won't lose me, but I think you should be able to identify that when I click start, like now, of this network degradation simulation, I would say, you probably see my video may be choppy, my audio is probably going to be choppy, and I'm going to just let it run there for a few seconds. And hopefully my connection won't drop completely. I'm gonna stop it now because I hear that the MOS score dropped. So what I did right now, introduce some packet loss in my complete system, right? So all the traffic going out and in from my laptop had a packet loss that caused this, as you can see here, this drop in MOS score, okay? And the same thing that you just saw in the video was captured here by NetBeans, showing this increased jitter, as you can see, right? Latency didn't change because the packet just dropped, right? It wasn't that the latency increased. The packet loss here doesn't really, let me see if I go to 5 minutes. So yeah, I went to the 5 minute interval here, and the packet loss also is shown here, that is around 3%. So as you know, packet loss is a very critical part of the, if it increases even like to 2 or 3%, it's probably too high to sustain a decent like voice or video call. Now moving on with one of the major additions of this past release, as of last week, release 7.0, we added Wi-Fi metrics for these remote worker agents. For the ones familiar with NetBeans, this view is similar across all agents. With the network agents or sensors we already had in place, we could display these metrics here. So RX and TX traffic out of the Wi-Fi interface. Link quality, which is a metric that that shows what is the RF environment of the device. Signal strength, again, what is the signal strength that the device is connected to the router with. If it's further from the router, that's going to drop. That may degrade your voice quality, the closer you are, the better, obviously, right? And bitrate is the bitrate that the device has negotiated with the router. And finally, channel, BSID, and SID. And of course, for all this, you have historical information, very useful for troubleshooting. When a user complains from home, usually you're completely blind around their Wi-Fi network, right? And the RF environment. But with this, at least you can make some correlation and either take this out of the picture being an issue, or the Wi-Fi may indeed be a picture. You might be able to advise your employee or your user and tell them, hey, maybe move your router, or you move close to the router, or at the end of the day, plug your laptop in, right? That, Wi-Fi cannot beat a wire, obviously, right? But that's also something you can look at. Another very important way here to troubleshoot Wi-Fi issues is to see the RF environment around the device. And this may be very critical for dense environments in apartment buildings, maybe. My network is pretty clean here, as you can see. I'm on the NetBIS SID. I'm on channel 149. I don't have actually anybody else on this channel, which is great for me. But you can imagine, you know, how big this can get, right? You can see many access points, many networks on the same channel, causing interference, co-channel interference. And you might be able, again, to see what's going on and advise your users to maybe configure the router to the appropriate channel, right? Try to ask them to change the channel with that they are working on. For the MAC agents around, so here, as you can see, we display link quality, signal strength, and bitrate. For the agents on macOS, we're able also to display the MCS, okay, metric, the modulation coding scheme metric, signal strength also, noise, right? Noise, and the rest are the same. The reason for the discrepancy between Mac and Windows is that Mac OS typically natively gives you these metrics, the MCS and the noise, while on Windows is not that straightforward to get that information, at least from all devices, all Windows machines. And that's why we display it here and not on the Windows side. The last thing I want to just complete this presentation with, this demo that has to do again with the user experience performance you're able to monitor with NetBIS, is around what we call schedule tests. A very typical test that probably you ask, you know, when somebody complains and you get on the phone with them, you know, asking an user to do, might be in a speed test, right? Of course, we all know the pitfalls of running a speed test and trying to determine your network performance or internet connectivity on that metric only. Because you are running a test over the internet towards an unknown server that might be oversubscribed by other speed tests as well. However, it's a very good baseline to have. That's how I see speed tests. You can schedule a speed test to run maybe overnight, right? Only on a machine. Which kind of, you know, you can create a baseline when the user probably does use their machine. And you can see how things are, and when something comes up, have the discrepancy. When things change from the baseline, might be indication of something going wrong. Now, the iPerf test here is another type of speed test or bandwidth test. For the ones not familiar, is a type of bandwidth test, again, that can run between two hosts. And that's more useful when you run an iPerf test, a bandwidth test, let's say over your VPN tunnel. In that case, you can set up an agent in your VPN concentrator and run a bandwidth test between the user's device and your VPN over the VPN tunnel, which again is a more reliable and more controlled way to run bandwidth tests than a speed test. And finally, the VoIP test we have here is a little bit different than the one I showed you earlier with the ping test. Because with this VoIP test, what you can do is that you can run a VoIP test between two NetBIS agents simulated call. And the way this fits well with some environments is when you can spin up a NetBIS agent in a VPN, in a VoIP concentrator. And then in that case, you can run an end-to-end actual VoIP simulated call between the user's device and the VPN, the VoIP concentrator, as opposed to the emulated other type of VoIP test we have that I showed you earlier, which is based on the ICMP traffic. And with that, I want to stick to the 20-minute timeline here, I'm going to try to answer a couple of questions. I would say, if you need more information around this, please reach out by going to our website, denbis.net. You can request a demo, chat with us. We're very responsive and answering questions. And I'm going to jump on a couple of other questions that came on through our Q&A chat window here. One question is, how does Wi-Fi rank in terms of all of the network performance issues experienced by remote users? That's a very interesting question, because the answer actually now has change, right? Before the pandemic, let's say everybody was on campus, everybody was using enterprise grade Wi-Fi equipment. The IT support was on campus with the user to support them. And in those cases, we're often hearing from users that they were proving they were using NetBIOS to prove that it's not the network or the Wi-Fi network causing the problems. That was a very common use case. Now it's the opposite, actually, because now is everybody's working from home. They have consumer grade Wi-Fi. They had to use Wi-Fi in most cases because they weren't able to plug in their laptop. And in this case, it's more common to hear that, of course, when the IT comes in to support a user or the help desk, that the Wi-Fi or the network is the problem, right? And of course, the difference is that the support team doesn't have control over the network or the Wi-Fi router of the other end user. And either, you know, they can answer the question, hey, you have to fix out your Wi-Fi, or they can focus their attention somewhere else. What Windows and macOS versions do you support? So for on Windows side, we support Windows 7 and Windows 10. And on the Mac side, we support High Sierra and earlier. And we'll support the latest M1 Mac processor. And what's the best way to determine the VPN performance? So through my presentation, I touched upon this, but to summarize about VPN performance, is one thing, of course, is to, you know, you can keep an eye on the user's VPN connectivity, if it's connected or not, by looking at the, you know, VPN status here, because a user might try to access a VPN service and they may not, you know, connect to their VPN first, right? So that's one thing, of course, that's very basic. And then the example we had here is where we can set up, if you have a split tunnel, a VPN test to an IP that's you know, behind your VPN concentrator, can be a simple ICMP or a trace route. And then in terms of VPN performance, you can stop an IPERF test that again is from a NetBIOS agent, another agent sitting in your data center over your VPN, and measure the bandwidth of the actual VPN tunnel. And let me see. Yeah, and for that, that was the last question. I covered the one that just came in about the VPN connectivity. And yeah, I would say again, if you want to reach out and learn more about this, you know where to find us, on our website, we're on Twitter, and we'll be happy to talk with you in person. Thank you.